Hey guys, what's up? My name is Serge, and in today's video, we'll take a look at how to reframe your clips in Final Cut Pro using the built-in transform tool. This can be used to zoom in on video, level out the horizon, add a picture-in-picture display, and even flip your image either horizontally or vertically. The transform tool included in Final Cut Pro can be used to resize, move, and rotate your image. There are two ways to access this tool in Final Cut Pro. You can either access the transform tool by selecting it from the drop-down menu under the viewer and use the on-screen controls for adjustment, or simply select the clip in your timeline, and in the video inspector, use the adjustment parameters in the transform section. First, let's take a look at the controls. When you select the transform tool from the drop-down menu in the viewer, a wireframe with control handles appears around your image. To adjust your image, you simply click and drag one of these control handles. Clicking and dragging one of the corner handles allows you to resize your image while maintaining the aspect ratio. What this means is any adjustments will be applied equally on both the X and the Y axes. Using the blue handles in the middle allow you to independently adjust the vertical or horizontal image size, changing the aspect ratio. The white circle in the middle is used to reposition your image, and the blue handle extending from the white circle lets you rotate the image. If you ever need to go back to the original image size, simply click the reset button in the top corner of the viewer. Let's take a look at a few practical examples of using the transform tool. In our first example, let's use the transform tool to resize and reposition our image to get the camera out of the frame. Place your playhead over your clip, make sure the clip is selected, and from the drop-down menu, select the transform tool. Use one of the corner handles to make your clip larger, and drag the white circle in the middle to reposition your clip. You may need to go back and forth to get the framing just right. If you can't see the handles, simply zoom out on your viewer window. Once you're happy with your framing, click Done in the top right corner. In our next example, let's use the transform tool to level out the horizon in our next clip. To make this easier, from the View drop-down menu above the viewer, select Show Horizon to enable a horizon overlay for reference. Next, select the Transform tool from the drop-down menu and use the blue control handle extending from the middle to rotate your image. For more precise adjustments, drag this handle away from the middle. As you rotate your image, as you can see, you get some black areas in your frame. To fill these in, you can either click and drag one of the corner control handles or use the Scale All slider in the Video Inspector. Drag this up until your entire frame is filled. Click Done and turn off your Horizon Overlay. For our next clip, let's use the Transform tool to make a picture-in-picture display. Select the clip you want to display in your picture-in-picture window and add it to your timeline above your clip. With your top clip selected, go to the Video Inspector, and in the Transform controls, bring down the Scale All slider. To move your picture-in-picture display, bring up the on-screen controls by clicking the Transform icon, and use the white circle in the middle to reposition your clip. You can also click and drag the value beside the position parameters in the inspector, or even manually enter the number. And last, let's take a look at how we can use the transform tool to horizontally or vertically flip images. Once again, place your playhead over the clip, select your clip, and from the drop-down menu, select the transform tool. Now, to flip an image horizontally, you can either click and drag one of the middle handles to the opposite side of the viewer window, or enter -100 for the scale X value. Just like that, your image is flipped to face the opposite direction. You can also flip your image vertically by entering -100 for the Y value. You can also keyframe all these transform parameters to animate your video clip and even add some cool effects. If you enjoyed this video and you haven't yet, check out the rest of my channel for more Final Cut Pro tutorials like this one. New videos every week. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you back here next week.